Hello guys, welcome to a new video where I'm building a complete microservices architecture with Kubernetes and Spring Cloud. In this video, I will show how to set up a service discovery in Kubernetes. Don't blink, because this will be very fast. Let's start by subscribing to my YouTube channel, and here we go. In the microservices world, the service discovery is a very useful pattern. It helps me to discover where and how to request the other services present in my architecture. Spring Cloud has a library for that, Netflix Eureka. But today I will use the Kubernetes configuration to reach that need. My target is to create a bookstore web application. For that, I've already created some microservices. The backend user, the service books, the service orders, and service prices. Those three microservices need a database to read the information. And this one will request them. It will be the public entry point of my architecture. I've created a deployment configuration for each microservice to have them running in my Kubernetes cluster, and one more for the database. I know it's not the correct way to do it, but the purpose of this video is not there. I've specified two replicas at each deployment. The Docker image to use it, the pull policy, never, because I use Minikube in my local environment and I want the Docker images to be pulled locally. And I've configured a readiness and a liveness probes. I've also created a service configuration for each microservices, with the port mapping to the target port 80, and the service type is ClusterIP. ClusterIP means that all the pods which compose the deployment will be behind a single IP. With this configuration, I have a single IP for the cluster of pods. Requesting this IP will redirect to a single pod with an internal load balancer using some round-robin strategy. The problem is that I don't want an IP. I want a URL or some kind of DNS record. For that, I will use the DNS service from Kubernetes. For each system in the Kubernetes environment, I have a DNS record created. Kubernetes automatically creates a DNS record for each system. This record has the following structure of the services: the name of the service, the namespace, I use the default one, the service abbreviation, which in my case is SVC, and the zone, which in my case is global.local, where my service is located in my cluster. I will first use this DNS record to access the database from the microservices. And now I need that my backend user requests the internal services with the built-in DNS record. For that, I will use Retrofit. With Retrofit, I create just some interfaces which describe each request. And behind that, Retrofit will perform the request. It will transform from an object to a JSON content and the response from JSON content to an object. Let's start by adding the Maven dependency. And now create the interfaces I need, one per microservice, which I need to communicate. And I will create the methods to access each endpoint I need into each microservice. and now configure the interfaces to request the adequate DNS record. Last step, use the interface in the services to request the adequate microservice. Okay, let's recap what I've done until now. I've created 4 microservices done with Spring Boot. 3 of them need a database, and the other is the only which should have a public endpoint. I've configured the deployment configuration for the microservices with 2 replicas. I've configured the service configuration for the microservices with ClusterIP for the privates and load balancer for the public one. The load balancer will make the service available publicly. And I've used the Kubernetes DNS record name in the application to request them internally. Let's now build all of this and test it. I will first compile all the projects with Maven and then build the Docker images into my Minikube cluster. Okay, I've built all my microservices into Docker images. I won't use service orders because my fan is already making a lot of noise. Let's now create the deployments in Kubernetes. Let's see the state. Seems right. Let's see the logs. Started correctly. Let's now create the servers for the database. Here it is. Now I can create the microservices which needs the database. Let's continue with the others. Okay, all my deployments are ready. Let's now create the associated services to make them available in the network. Here I have all my services. The internal services with the cluster IP and the public one with the load balancer. And finally, expose the public microservices backend user outside Minikube. Here I have the IP. Let's request it. I have a result. The public microservice backend user called service prices and service books to obtain this information, to obtain this result. Let's make more requests to see they are not handled by the same pod. If I take a look at the first pod of backend user, I see that two requests went here. And if I take a look at the logs of service books, I see that two requests came here. Two of the five requests, they were splitted into the two replicas. With the service discovery, I don't need to know how many replicas, how many pods there are in the same microservice. I don't need to bother about requesting always the same pod, because there is already a round-robin strategy. Implementing the service discovery the way I show it in this video, I give all the responsibility to Kubernetes DNS servers. Other alternatives will be to have a dedicated microservice which handles the service discovery with libraries like Spring Cloud or Eureka, but this I will show in another video. Important pattern that needs to be well understood. It's the key to let the microservices communicate between them. I hope you enjoyed it, because I almost enjoyed making the project. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this one. Click on the like button and see you in the next video. Bye!